About 66 million years ago, at the end of the Cretaceous period, the planet lost its dinosaurs. But how did the dinosaurs go extinct? Of course, this happened because of a global catastrophe. But do you know what happened right after the mass extinction? If we could go back in time for a while, we would find a world completely different than what we're used to thinking today. We would find a planet that was almost destroyed by a meteor strike. A suffering planet. A desolate planet. The same planet that learned how to get back on track. Our planet Earth. Follow me on this journey back 66 million years ago to find out what happened in the first minutes after the dinosaurs disappeared. I promise you'll be amazed. When? At the end of the Mesozoic era. The Mesozoic, middle life, is one of the three geologic eras of the Phanerozoic Eon, preceded by the Paleozoic, ancient life, and succeeded by the Cenozoic, new life. The era is subdivided into three major periods, the Triassic, Jurassic, and Cretaceous, which are further subdivided into a number of epochs and stages. What happened? A huge asteroid came and smashed into the Earth, even if scientists still argue about this. The diameter of this celestial body was something like 11 to 80 kilometers. It might be the size of the city of Washington, D.C. Such a collision couldn't pass without a trace. The world changed in an instant. This is how the dinosaurs died. Chapter 1. Total devastation. Actually, around 75% of Earth's animals, including dinosaurs, suddenly died out at the same point in time. So how was it all caused by a rock hurtling into the coast of Central America? Let's explain it in a better way. The asteroid hit at high velocity and effectively vaporized. The asteroid left behind a giant crater. The crater covered the entire Gulf of Mexico, and it has a diameter of 150 kilometers, 93 miles, and a depth of 20 kilometers, 12 miles. So in the immediate area, there was total devastation. Chapter 2. Lights off and mega tsunamis. A huge blast wave and heat wave went out, and it threw vast amounts of material up into the atmosphere. Soot didn't completely block out the sun, but it reduced the amount of light that reached the Earth's surface, so it had some impact on the growth of vegetation. The impact caused mega tsunamis with a height of more than 100 meters, 330 feet. That reached the territory of modern-day Texas and Florida. Other sources indicate a height of 300 meters, 985 feet. That's, for example, the height of the Eiffel Tower. The asteroid displaced so much water that huge waves crashed onto the coastline for 10 hours. The explosion that occurred when the tsunami crashed was 100 million times more powerful than the famous thermonuclear Tsar Bomba. Chapter 3. Consequences on the food chain. Like dominoes, this trailed up the food chain, causing the ecosystem to collapse. The reduction in plant life had a huge impact on herbivores' ability to survive, which in turn meant that carnivores would also have suffered from having less food available. Breeding seasons would have been shorter and conditions harsher. All living things would have been affected in some way, both on land and in the ocean. There is a lot of discussion over the actual kill mechanism and how long that period lasted. There are still a lot of unknowns, but it was a massive event affecting all life on Earth, from microorganisms all the way through to dinosaurs. The casualty list is long, among them ammonites, some microscopic plankton, and large marine reptiles all died out. But the loss made room for the beginnings of the modern world. Chapter 4. Consequences on global climate change. The blame can't solely rest on the asteroid. Before its crash landing, Earth was experiencing a period of climate change. This was making things harder for life on our planet. In what is now central India, there was a substantial volcanic activity, although unrelated to the asteroid impact, was causing problems of its own. The resulting lava outcrop is now known as the Deccan Traps. For 2 million years, there was a huge amount of volcanic activity going on, spewing gases into the atmosphere and having a major impact on global climate. There were also longer-term changes. The continents were drifting around and splitting apart from each other, creating bigger oceans, which changed ocean and atmospheric patterns around the world. This also had a strong effect on climate and vegetation. During the Cretaceous extinction event, plants were less affected than animals because their seeds and pollen can survive harsh periods for longer. After the dinosaurs' extinction, flowering plants dominated Earth, continuing a process that had started in the Cretaceous and continued to do so today. But all land animals weighing over 25 kilograms died out. What we're left with are basically the seeds of what we have today. Many of the major animal groups that are alive today were in place before the asteroid impact, and they all suffered some level of extinction, but the lines that led to modern animals got through. Before continuing to watch, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel, clicking the bell, so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Chapter 5. Surviving and Recovering. These events were indescribably destructive. The asteroid impact that ended the Cretaceous period shut down photosynthesis for years and caused decades of global cooling. Anything that couldn't shelter from the cold or find food in the darkness, which was most species, perished. Perhaps 90% of all species disappeared in just a few years. Water ecosystem was also destroyed, but not completely. For example, turtles managed to survive. Researchers called the environment of that time lunar, desolate and barren as it was. It was almost impossible to survive in such conditions, yet life on our planet didn't stop. All of the non-bird dinosaurs died out, but dinosaurs survived as birds. Some types of birds did go extinct, but the lineage that led to modern birds survived. But life bounced back, and the recovery was rapid. The foraminifera was the first to recover. These are single-celled organisms that appear in the crater a few years after the impact. When the ferns awoke, in just a millennium, they were able to spare and occupy a lot of space that was left. 90% of mammal species were eliminated by the asteroid, but they recovered, and then some within 300,000 years, going on to evolve into horses, whales, bats, and our primate ancestors. Birds and fish experienced similarly rapid recovery and radiation. And many other organisms, snakes, tuna, and swordfish, butterflies and ants, grasses, orchids, and asters evolved or diversified at the same time. This pattern of recovery and diversification happened after every mass extinction. The end-Permian extinction saw mammal-like species take a hit, but reptiles flourished afterwards. After the reptiles suffered during the end-Triassic event, the surviving dinosaurs took over the planet and diversified. Although a mass extinction ended the dinosaurs, they only evolved in the first place because of mass extinction. Despite this chaos, life slowly diversified over the past 500 million years. In fact, several things hint that extinction drives this increased diversity. For one, the most rapid periods of diversity increase occur immediately after mass extinctions. But perhaps more striking, recovery isn't only driven by an increase in species numbers. In a recovery, animals innovate, finding new ways of making a living. They exploit new habitats, new foods, new means of locomotion. For example, our fish-like forebears first crawled onto land after the end-Devonian extinction. Oceans recovered much more slowly. Scientists estimate that it took about 3 million years. Only then did the flow of organic material return to normal, with new species taking over the vacant ecological niches. Conclusions: could the dinosaurs have survived? There is research to suggest that if the impact had occurred elsewhere on the planet, the fate of life on Earth could have been very different. If it had fallen just minutes later, the asteroid would have landed in deeper water, causing less rock to vaporize and rise to block out the sun's light and warmth. This would have lowered the chances of mass extinction. But if the dinosaurs' reign hadn't been abruptly ended by an asteroid, some scientists think that we might have seen some, other than birds, around today. They suspect some of them would still be around. Some other scientists say that if the meteor had hit a few million years before, when a richer array of herbivore dinosaurs populated North America, or a few million years later, when the salad-munching giants had recovered some diversity, the space rock may not have triggered a dinopocalypse, the researcher said. Experiencing the meteor impact was a bit like getting hit by a bus, scientist Broussat said. Having low herbivore diversity would be like limping across the road with a sprained ankle. You're more likely to get run over, he said. What if an exact twin of this asteroid hit us tomorrow? NASA has given some advice on what to do if a large asteroid does crash into us. It simply reads, pray. In reality, we would probably get a few months of warning, as the asteroid itself would be very easy to spot. A few months is not a long time at all to dig bunkers or make people safe. Or at this point in time, we do not have the technology to deflect or change the asteroid's course. The time would need to be spent making safe places for as many of us as possible, either by going underground or underwater, as far from the crash zone as possible. Of course, the whole world would be in a state of panic, even though for most of the time the sky would remain as it is now. As the asteroid gets closer, it would remain silent, even as it enters the atmosphere as many times the speed of sound. When the asteroid finally hits the Earth, a force of 100 trillion tons of TNT or more than a billion Hiroshima bombs would be imposed on us. The Earth's crust is instantly vaporized, and a fireball four times the size of the sun is created. Grass, trees, and anything within 1,200 kilometers will be burnt instantly. Your only real chance of surviving all of this is if you are on the other side of the planet to the impact zone. Yet even here, you will hear and indeed feel the impact. The damage will still be inflicted upon to structures more than 5,000 kilometers away from the collision zone. Anything ejected from the impact will be shot miles into the air, heating our atmosphere by some 1,500 degrees centigrade. This would cause forest fires, and the sky would darken as the sunlight is blocked by the dust. Most people will need to stay in the safety bunkers for some time. This is what experts think happened to the dinosaurs. However, maybe us humans would be able to survive all this. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. What did you know about dinosaur extinction? Did you find this information useful? Were you amazed by the huge impact the asteroid had? Is there anything more you want to hear about dinosaurs? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.